Hello friends, and welcome back to Josh's Life with Plushies. It is Friday, June 7th, 2024. Just finished my work day and about to head home, walk back to the car for the drive home. It is roughly 21 degrees Celsius, feels like 21. Wind is pretty mild, I think it was 11 kilometers an hour, gusting to 23, so not too bad out there. And yeah, we'll touch base with you in a minute. All right, friends, we are walking back to the car now. Last clip I left off. My mind spaced out there, but basically I wanted to introduce you to Marie. I've got Marie with me today here from the Arista Cats, part of the Big Feet plush collection here. Just give me a minute here to walk back out onto the sidewalk there. I was walking along the building just to leave. But we have Marie here. Cute as a button. She's got her little bow there on the top. Little pink ears, eyelashes, her little hands there, her big feet, of course, or in this case, her big paws. And she's got her bow on the back, a big silky bow, just for perspective on size, next to my hand there. And then her tail, of course, all fluffed up. So, it's been a while since I've vlogged. Again, a few days. Life's just been kind of crazy. Mood is kind of following the weather. We had some not so nice weather lately. A lot of cloudy days. And that's made for some kind of more bummed out feelings. So it just makes it difficult to get out and vlog about stuff. Life's been pretty heavy. Just yesterday at work, we had an all-staff meeting. Out of the blue, CEO sends an email out and says everyone to meet in a specific location at work there with 15-minute notice about some sad news. Get there to find out that a coworker passed away, tragically, from a cycling accident. Well, they weren't the ones who had the accident. The vehicle hit them, didn't stay at the scene to report the incident, took off. They found the driver, and the driver is being charged, not sure with what, but unfortunately he did pass away from that. So it's been a lot of heavy news, a lot of heavy stuff going on, and so of course that's affecting the mood at work with coworkers and stuff. We're all dealing with grief, grieving the loss of a coworker. Some were closer to this coworker than I was. I'm sure if I saw the face, I'd recognize them, but the name wasn't familiar, and it's not someone that I interacted with consistently or frequently. But it's still heavy, right? Because you have other coworkers that you're close to that are dealing with that, dealing with the grief. And we're just in an environment where we deal with a lot of that kind of stuff on a daily basis, and it can get heavy, and it can get to be a lot to carry through your day with you and still be present for other guests who are visiting the museum for the first time. So it's just a lot of energy. It's just taking a lot of energy to get through that. Today is a much nicer day out weather-wise. It's sunny, so that's nice. That helps a lot for sure. I've got some clouds overhead here. They're kind of all around me. I'm not sure if I'll be able to see. So that's the direction that I'm walking towards behind me there, but now ahead of me. And so it's just been, it's been a lot. And there's those fans again that I'm walking by in typical fashion. Wind, that windy sound. Like we got some skateboarders going by. Those are some loud wheels on those skateboards, but river's flowing. Looks like the water level is pretty high as well. That's yeah. Anyways, what's on tap for tonight? Groceries are on tap for tonight. That's about it. Lunch prep and groceries. And then work again tomorrow on Saturday. So we'll catch up with you a little bit later. We have made it home. We are in the garage, just about to head in for supper. Pizza for supper tonight. And I went to open the door on the like main public road out there. I park really close to the curb, near the park where I park near work. Anyways, and so I was walking in within my lane still, and with my door open, it's still within my lane. Like, it's not even the white dotted lines. It doesn't even cross that line. But there was a school bus going by, or about to go by, and I opened my door, and I guess the driver didn't like that, and he tooted his horn, and then I saw him in the window lift his hand up, like, all frustrated. I'm like, serious? I'm not going to wait for traffic to clear just to be able to get into my vehicle to head home. And I'm within the safe limits of what I feel is safe for myself. And I'm not infringing in the other lanes of traffic. So, obviously that person was just having a day. It is what it is. Just shook it off and said, hey, you're having a bad day. I forgive you. I don't need to hold on to it. I don't need to be upset about it. Obviously, like, inside of me was like, ooh, right away. I'm like, getting angry, and had some unkind words in my mind of what I would have liked to say, but then I'm like, nah, I don't need to get angry about it. I don't need to hold it. I don't need to internalize it. I don't need to personalize it. Just let it go. You're okay. I'm okay. Let's just move on. So, yeah, anyways, that was a potential moment where I could have just been angry and crabby and bitter the rest of the night, and I'm choosing to just talk about it and release it. And so that's what I'm doing. Marie and I are going to go in and have some supper. Then we got some shopping to do, some lunch prep to do. And that'll be pretty much it for the night. Oh, yeah. And at work yesterday, amidst all of the craziness, so there's two roles that I do within my role. One is kind of more leadership-based opportunity that gets spread out amongst all of the staff who meet the goals and requirements to be able to do that role. Anyways, yesterday was kind of sort of that leadership role. So I get to be the lead for the day for certain things to be accessible, to bring things into gallery, all those kind of things. Anyways, so amidst the chaos of yesterday, because I was kind of like essentially a floater employee who could go anywhere, I just filled in the gaps of places where staff needed to exit the gallery in order to get the news or go to the news or deal with the grief in whatever way they needed to deal with. And at the end of the day, my supervisor or my assistant manager, who I report to directly, she came to me and she asked me, she's like, you know, how are you? I didn't get a chance to talk to you much today, but I wanted to check in with you and see how you're doing. And I was like, yeah, I'm doing okay. And she's like, you know, I know you're a highly empathetic person, and like you take things very personally, and you empathize very personally, and so I just wanted to make sure that you had a safe space to talk about anything if you were feeling overwhelmed or any of those kind of things. And I was like, oh, no, I'm actually doing okay. I'm all right. So yeah. And then after that, she said, oh, and I want to thank you as well for doing an amazing job today. You did really good. So thank you. And I was like, oh, thank you. So it's always nice to hear those kind of things. It's nice to have a boss who recognizes those things, encourages those things in me. And it just helps get through some of that tough stuff as well. So anyways, I just thought I'd share that. Time to go in for supper, and we'll catch up with you later, either during grocery shopping or lunch prep or something else. So we'll see you in a bit. Okay, and quick pool update as I was heading into the house here. Marie and I are going to just take a little peek inside here and see what the temperature is. All right, our little floating whale. Pull that up to the... Okay, so let's see, we're reading about 19 Celsius. And then Fahrenheit, we're gonna say somewhere around... Sorry, it's shaking a little too much here. I want to say 2, 4, 6. About 66. Roughly. So not quite warm enough. Yeah, definitely cold. And here is the pizza that we're having tonight. Imported all the way from Italy, $7.99 Canadian. $7.99 Canadian freezer pizza. Friends, it's at that point in the night where we need to start unwinding, get ready for bed, get some good sleep, and be able to take on the day again tomorrow. So thank you for following along with us here today. One thought that's been on my mind as I've kind of gone throughout the day and thought about life and circumstances and where I'm at. I know that I've been doing some stretches lately, and they feel like exercises to me, honestly, because I've gone through a recent hernia surgery where I was unable to even move for a while. I was very limited in my movement and stuff, and so my muscles have kind of gone downhill. I'm over 40, and so apparently when your body is like near 40 years old or over 40, it just isn't what it used to be in its ability to bounce back or build. And so it requires more effort. And so anyways, it's felt like a lot of effort lately. And I've just been thinking about, okay, well, if I need to get back into exercising, what kind of exercises would I be interested in doing? And so I think for me, I'm not a big fan. I don't get a kick or like a drive or a fix off of, or a high off of like doing exercising where I'm all done and I'm like, whew, I just feel really good all of a sudden. I don't get that. Some people do. Are you one of those types of people? What kind of exercises do you enjoy doing? What is exercise for you? And so for me, I think the biggest thing is going to be just doing sports or daily activities that I enjoy doing. So like badminton, going for walks, you know, doing random exercise, random like woodworking things in the garage, those kind of things. I think those are kind of more where I'm at as far as exercising goes. But feel free to leave a comment on this video here and let me know what you think about exercising. Do you get that high? Do you get that fix? Do you do sports instead as exercising? Let's hear some of the ideas that you have. Maybe some of them we share together. And since you've made it this far, and if you've enjoyed watching this video, if you could give it a thumbs up, like that video, that helps support this video and this content a little bit more as well. I would appreciate it. Thank you for following along. And until tomorrow, stay plushy, friends.